The US military blasted off a rocket from a seaside launch pad in Virginia to test nearly a dozen hypersonic weapon experiments. As per reports, Sandia National Laboratories ran the test from NASA's Wallops Flight Facility in Virginia, which evaluated hypersonic weapon communications and navigation equipment, as well as advanced materials that can withstand the heat in a realistic hypersonic environment. The rocket carried 11 experiments and is the second test conducted as part of a program to enhance land and sea-based hypersonic capabilities. The first ever testing of this kind was carried out in October 2021. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how close is the US military to fielding hypersonic weapons. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. To speed the development of hypersonic weapons, the Pentagon launched these experiments using a sounding rocket. A sounding rocket is a smaller and therefore more affordable test vehicle. It fills a critical gap between ground testing and full system flight testing. These are generally one- or two-stage rockets, powered by a solid propellant for space exploration. The test was intended to validate future aspects of the US Navy's Conventional Prompt Strike (CPS) and the US Army's Long-Range Hypersonic Weapon (LRHW). Vice Admiral Johnny Wolf, the Director of Strategic Systems Programs who oversaw the test, said, "The launch today went extremely well. We've just got done looking through our key observables, and every piece of data we wanted to collect, at least preliminarily, has shown that we collected all that data." An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed the speed of Mach 5. That's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. The extreme speed of hypersonic weapons and the ability to fly in unpredictable paths give them a much higher probability of penetrating modern air defenses. They'll be very hard to track, let alone intercept. It's to be noted that traditional ballistic missiles also reach hypersonic speed when they descend down on the target, but they follow a predictable, predefined parabolic path, which leaves scope for interception by anti-ballistic missile defense systems. There are 3 methods being applied to make hypersonic weapons. 1. Using a scramjet engine like the Russian Zircon missile. 2. Through the use of a hypersonic glide vehicle, HGV. Examples of these are the Chinese DF-ZF, Russian Avant-Garde, and American CPS and LRHW. 3. Using ALBM, or air-launched ballistic missiles, like the Russian Kinzhal missile, which has been used in Ukraine. LRHW and CPS have defined timelines. US Army announced that the LRHW would be fielded in 2023. The system, which is said to have a reported range of 1,725 miles or 2,775 kilometers, is described in a Congressional Research Service report titled "The US Army's Long-Range Hypersonic Weapon." It reportedly consists of a ground-launched missile with a hypersonic glide body and related transport, support, and fire control equipment. The US Navy intends to deploy CPS by FY25. Such a weapon would allow the United States to respond far more swiftly to rapidly emerging threats than is possible with conventional forces. CPS is intended to complement existing American rapid response forces, such as forward deployed forces, air expeditionary groups, which can deploy within 48 hours, and carrier battle groups, which can respond within 96 hours. It will be an alternative to nuclear weapons for strategic retaliatory strikes for around 30% of targets. CPS was originally designed to deploy aboard U.S. Navy submarines, but they're now in line to be deployed to the Zumwalt warships, as well as several other platforms. Viewers may note that Common Hypersonic Glide Body, CHGB, which is the projectile atop the ballistic missile, will be used by both of the programs. The Common Hypersonic Glide Body is transported in a nose cone by the rocket booster. The rocket releases the CHGB once it's reached a significant altitude and speed. The CHGB then descends towards its target at hypersonic speeds. It's no secret that the US is lagging in the hypersonic weapons space, especially against Russia and China. As stated by US DoD leaders, hypersonic weapons are a national imperative. Michael E. White, principal director for hypersonics, had said some time back that the adversaries have increasingly focused on systems that dramatically compress the timelines and the time scale of a tactical battlefield. He indicated that the American portfolio of subsonic and supersonic weapons will be found wanting in battle. He stated that the U.S. Department of Defense, DOD, has developed the hypersonics modernization strategy that accelerates the development and delivery of transformational warfighting capabilities based on hypersonic systems. Well, it's still hard to say if the U.S. military can meet the timeline it has set for itself when it comes to LRHW and CPS. It's evident that a lot of funding and effort is going into accelerating hypersonic development. With the kind of budget the U.S. military possesses and the sharp minds engaged in this, it will not be surprising that it's able to develop and deploy a slew of hypersonic weapons in the very near future.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.